First of all, let me categorically state that we cannot stop flood. It's a natural occurring phenomenon, but sometimes being exacerbated by our actions or inactions, that is human interference in the environment. So if we cannot stop it, but we can focus, we can get ready, we can move things and people, properties, we can avoid putting things in floodplain, especially if there is this prediction. And that has been going on. Predicting work with several agencies, one of them being NIMED, that can tell us the prediction of how much rain we're expecting in a particular year. But also, occasionally there's also release of water from dams. All these people are warned, but sometimes, being nature what it is, even after being warned, if you don't move in time, it may come even sooner or later, all of this. So all that said and done. Currently, yes, some of the areas are still submerged, but we have started assessing how much damage has been done, the areas flooded, how much crops have been destroyed, have been damaged. The assessment is ongoing. We're also using our remote system satellite to assess areas. We have preliminary data, but we do not have all of it. Number three, for farmers especially, we always encourage farmers to take insurance. There are farmers that have taken insurance, so now is the time for compensation after we finish all the assessment. Number four, the government always will have a plan of action or emergency response just like this. What can the government do? What can the government do also to compensate those that don't have insurance? Not really compensation, but assist, come to their aid. We have that plan and we're already activating, pending one will finish all the assessment. What are we doing to avert food shortage? Number one, first and foremost, we have in place an intensive plan for dry season farming. We have gotten funding from the African Development Bank. We have some money also in our own provision. And also, IFAD, they have also just donated, or grant, if you will, $5 million. So we have some money that we are already planning to do dry season farming. Also, areas of conflict. We are recruiting additional rangers. Previously, I told you, I think in another forum that we have agro rangers that provide some measure of security on farmlands. We are recruiting more to do that. Also, we are intensifying farming in areas that have no conflict to make up for those areas that we are getting little or no access. So the thing is, the government, Mr. President, has specifically directed that we do everything humanly possible to make sure there is no food shortage in the country. And I can tell you, there will not be any food shortage. Between the Federal Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development, the Central Bank, and other private investors in Agric, there's enough grains in the silos, in our own silos, in the CBN silos, that will cater for any eventualities. And currently, humanitarian ministry is picking up some grains from us to distribute to the needy. So I can assure you, by the grace of God, there will be no food shortage.